Good morning, and welcome to worship on this second Sunday in Lent. Today, we welcome Lutheran Campus Ministry, who will be leading our worship service. Much thanks to Katie Wagner, Lutheran Campus Ministry Director, and all the students who are helping to lead worship today. I share with you first a few announcements and OSL ministry updates. First, I want to remind you that we are gathering for live virtual worship on Wednesday nights during Lent. Lenten Wednesday worship begins at 6:30 p.m., and you can find a link to that live worship right on the front page of our website, oslme.com. Matins, that is morning prayer, continues every Wednesday at 9 a.m. That service is also live and virtual. If you would like information about how to participate, please contact Pastor Sarah and she will get you connected. I will be leading two backpack groups this summer to Christicon, an ELCA backpacking camp in the mountains of Montana. There are still some spots open. There will be an adult backpacking group and a high school backpacking group that I'll be leading out west. Please contact me if you would like to learn more about that fun adventure and opportunity. During this season of Lent, our Muau Committee, that is our Ministry Outside Our Walls Committee, invites you to consider helping support Stepping Stones as your Lenten offering, particularly emergency housing that Stepping Stones provides for those in our community who need shelter. During this pandemic, the safest shelter is for an individual or a family to stay in a hotel room. Each hotel stay costs about $70. And during these cold months, with so many economic hardships and with the additional COVID challenges that individuals and families face, we invite you to help provide financial support to shelter those in need. Perhaps you can think about sheltering folks for a night or two or 10 at that $70 expense. You can send your donations directly to Stepping Stones with the designation shelter included in the memo line. Finally, I invite you to hold in prayer those we know to be in need this week. We pray for the family of Ron Huseby, who passed away February 18th. And we continue to hold in our prayers Audric Boer, Brad Wozniak, Carol May, and David Bauer. I remind you that if you have a prayer concern or would like to visit with one of your pastors or a parish nurse, please reach out to us. We are here for you. All of our contact information can be found on our website at oslme.com. We now begin worship as we welcome Lutheran Campus Ministry.
Welcome to worship on this Sunday morning. We are doing another virtual Lutheran Campus Ministry Sunday so we can continue to worship with you all even though we're not able to safely gather together in person. We greatly miss being with you all, but hope this little glimpse of the students and hearing the message will help you to remember those times when we can all be together and the times that we will be together again. Thank you for joining us this morning. We begin with our confession and forgiveness.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, the one who fashions us, the one who heals us, the one who reforms us again and again. Amen. Sources of all life, we confess that we have not allowed your grace to set us free. We fear that we are not good enough. We hear your word and love freely given to us, yet we expect others to earn it. We turn the church inward rather than moving it outward. Forgive us. Stir us. Reform us to a church powered by love, willing to speak for what is right, act for what is just, and seek the healing of your whole creation. Amen. God hears our cry and sends the Spirit to change us and to empower us. He lives in the world. Our sins are forgiven, God's love is unconditional, and we all are raised up as God's people who will always be made new. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Please join us for our gathering song, Here I Am to Worship, led by the LCM Praise Band.
Thank you. Our first reading comes from Romans, the 4th chapter. For the promise that he would inherit the world did not come to Abraham or to his descendants through the law, but through the righteousness of faith. If it is the adherents of the law who are to be the heirs, faith is null and the promise is void. For the law brings wrath, but where there is no law, neither is there violation. For this reason, it depends on faith, in order that the promise may rest on grace and be guaranteed to all his descendants. Not only to the adherents of the law, but also to those who share the faith of Abraham. For he is the father of all of us, as it is written, I have made you the father of many nations. In the presence of the God in whom he believed, who gives life to the dead and calls into existence the things that do not exist. Hoping against hope, he believed that he would become the father of many nations, according to what was said, so numerous shall your descendants be. He did not weaken in faith where he considered his own body, which was already as good as dead, for he was about 100 years old, or when he considered the barrenness of Sarah's womb. No distrust made him waver concerning the promise of God, but he grew strong in his faith as he gave glory to God, being fully convinced that God was able to do what he had promised. Therefore, his faith was reckoned to him as righteousness. In other words, it was reckoned to him, were written not for his sake alone, but for ours also. It will be reckoned to us who believe in him who raised Jesus our Lord from the dead, who was handed over to dead for our trespasses and raised for our justification. This is the word of the Lord.
Our gospel reading comes from Mark, the 8th chapter. Then he began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering, and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. He said all this quite openly. And Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, Get behind me, Satan, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things. He called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who want to lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. For what will it profit them to gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of them the Son of Man will also be ashamed when he comes in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Grace, mercy, and peace will be with us. Love, forgiveness, and hope are within us. In the name of God, who sent Jesus and the Holy Spirit to show us that we matter and we are loved. Amen. When I was in middle school, and maybe even high school, I wanted to fit in with people. I wanted to have the right kind of shoes, the right brand of clothes, the right everything. And if you think back to when you were that age, or maybe you're that age right now, I bet you felt the same way. We wanted friends to like us and so desperately to belong to something. For me, though, I was a kid who loved going to church and liked to participate in just about anything they offered, from choir to confirmation to camp, you name it. But when I was that age, my friends' opinions were really important to me, and not all of my friends liked to go to church. So I questioned myself. I even denied myself a few times because I wanted to be included and not to stand out. I think about this struggle that many of us have experienced or are experiencing when I read today's gospel from Mark. If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. Deny myself? If I'm being honest, I've struggled with this idea of denying myself to follow Jesus. Maybe you've even questioned that yourself at some point when you've heard this passage. I think sometimes we see this as giving up pieces of ourselves, things that are unique, things we're passionate about, just to follow Jesus. But what if we take this idea of denying ourselves and take it literally? Hang in there with me for a minute. What if we denied situations when it seeks to break our relationships with one another? What if we deny the things that break down community? What if we denied the feelings that seek to bring us farther from one another in understanding and in love? Now, I'm not saying that we get rid of all the things that make us unique and make us who we are at our core. But what I'm challenging you to think about today is that when Jesus says we are to deny ourselves and take up our cross, that we see this as an invitation into what the cross truly means for us. Not just the death and suffering of Jesus Christ for our sins, but that God chooses us. God chooses human relationship for us and for our neighbor. I think this is what Jesus could be referring to. During this Lenten season, we are reminded of our own humanity. During Ash Wednesday, we have ashes placed on our forehead and hear the words, "Remember, you are dust, and to dust you shall return." Each one of us. You and your neighbor hear the same words as the body of Christ and as faith community together. We do not do Lent alone. We do not do faith alone. Think about Ash Wednesdays when we were not in a pandemic. You would maybe go to the grocery store and see someone else with ashes on their head. You would know that you had this solidarity in community with Christ and community with one another. Lent is a time when we realize that this is not just about us. Lent is a denial of yourself in one of the best ways that embraces community and reminds us that we deeply desire to belong to God and to one another. So today's gospel is not about denying our true selves. Jesus does not ask us nor want us to give up the things that make us who we are, but instead asks us to consider how some things we do might get in the way of the belonging, relationships with God and relationships with our neighbor. We need others around us to remind us that God is around us. We need God to remind us that we don't have to do everything on our own. We need our neighbor to remind us that there are more people in this community of faith than those present here or those in your congregation. So here's our chance as children of God to live into the fullness of the cross of Christ and deny ourselves as Christ expresses to us in this passage. Let us deny the impulses that seek to tell us that we have to do things on our own or rely on only ourselves. Let us deny the thoughts that we have all the answers. Let us deny the negative feelings that we aren't good enough or worthy enough for God or for another. Live into the strength in community and the ways that we lift one another up in faith and life. Live into becoming curious about life, about another's experience, about how God is at work in the world, and what God means to you. Live into the unconditional love that comes from God that reminds you every day that you are worthy, you are loved, you are good. We need relationships as human beings. We find comfort in relationship, in that feeling when you're with a friend or family member that you feel like you can be your true self with. If I could tell my middle school self one thing, I think it would be this. Don't ever deny who you truly are, because God loves your quirks, your passions, your strengths, loves you when you make mistakes and in your weaknesses. When we are in relationship with God, and we all are, we are loved and worthy in all those moments of life. When we feel unlovable or unworthy, God is right there to lift us up in the comforting hug or words of a friend, or in hearing the word on a Sunday morning. Friends in Christ, I will tell you the same thing. Don't ever deny who you truly are, because God loves you. God wants to be in relationship with you. God wants us to be in relationship with one another, as we are the body of Christ together. Think about what an amazing gift that is. To deny the things that tear us out of relationship, to deny hate, to deny divisiveness, and to let the love of God fill our very souls. Live into that love. A different kind of denial, indeed. For this, we can say thanks be to God. Amen. I invite you now to join with the LCM Praise Band again in singing, Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone, for we can be who we truly are meant to be. Let's sing.
Pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Loving God, as humans we long to be in relationships. Help us deny the things that seek to tear us apart, distance us from you and from one another. You seek us out and never leave us. Give us faith to trust in that promise every day. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of compassion, you know all our hurts and sorrows. Give healing to all who need it, in body, mind, and soul. Inspire us to bring your love and compassion to all who suffer. Pity be with those whose names are in our hearts and minds, and those known only to you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of calling, we thank you for instilling in us unconditional love shown to us through Jesus Christ. We thank you for lifting up in us our own talents, passions, and gifts to serve you and share the love with others. Help us to lift the strengths and joys of others as we work together in ministry. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, we pray for our country and for leaders around the world. Inspire them to lead with hearts of compassion and justice. Help them work for peace. Remind us to speak up for the oppressed, the forgotten, and the left out. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, help us to remember that we are never too far from you or your love. We are redeemed through your loving and saving grace, and salvation comes to us in Jesus Christ. May we work together to share this good news with everyone we meet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we remember that your church is found in all corners of creation. Bless all the churches across the world that preach a gospel of love and welcome. Inspire us to take the message and the mission of the church beyond the walls of our building. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always, and also with you. We invite you to share a sign of peace with those around you or in the comments.
We would like to thank you for your continued support of Lutheran Campus Ministry, especially during this very strange time. Since we've had to cancel many fundraising events this year, we appreciate your donation now more than ever. You can either mail in a donation to the ministry at 710 2nd Street East, Menominee, Wisconsin 54751, or you can visit our webpage, www.lcmstout.com, go to the Donate tab or the link on the homepage to make an electronic donation. Again, we appreciate your donation, big or small. All of it helps to support our ministry. You are also invited to participate in our monthly raffle ticket fundraiser with a drawing on the first of every month. More information for that can be found on our Facebook page and on our website. And our next raffle is coming up on March 1st. Our drawing will be held at between 7:15 and 7:30 p.m. So you can watch our Facebook page for that. Again, thank you for your support of our ministry. We would not be able to do what we do with the students without you.
Let us pray together as Jesus has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
And now receive the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. We invite you to join again one final time with our LCM Praise Band as we sing together, Light of the World.
You are the light of the world.
peace, to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen.